breaks the news, a secret memorial for Johnny. Hello, everybody. I'm Mary Hart. First, Jerry Seinfeld, Jay Leno, Chris Rock, Hollywood's funniest guys gather to say goodbye to the man who gave them their big breaks.
They were here for hours, actually. They finished their dinner and then they stayed for hours.
The stars who gathered at Dan Tana's restaurant last night paid tribute to Johnny with laughs.
It was wonderful to see the group of comedians laughing and having fun. He would be very happy if he heard what they were saying about him.
Tuesday night memorial dinner at Dan Tana's West Hollywood restaurant.
I offered to buy him after dinner drink. They didn't want to drink. They were not drinking, but they said, you can pick up the check.
Kevin Frazier found out the guys were kidding. They did pay the $434 check.
The bill was split between Gary Shandling and Jerry Seinfeld.
Posle 53 godine vratio sam se nazad u Beograd, gde sam momentalno. Međutim, ja sam pre 5-6 godina bila želja da se vratim, da sam rođen i da proživim deo mog života koji sam promašio da proživim u mom gradu. Tražio sam stan ovde i našao sam stan u ovoj zgradi. Zaljubio sam se u ovu zgradu koja je građena pre Drugog svetskog rata, mada u to doba nije bilo automobila, ovde je bilo mirno, ptice su pevale. Na ovom divnom ulazu gde je bila portirnica pre rata, momentalno je jedno skladište koje mi upotrebljavamo za razno čišćenje ovde. Kupio sam sat ovaj, a naravno kad sam kupio sat, komšije su mi rekli taj sat neće biti dugo ovde. Verujte, ovo je treći sat ovde, dva su već ukrali. Ili se neko poslužio, možda nije ni ukrao. Ali ja, da se osiguram, ja sam kupio 10 satova, tako da imam još 7 da im menjam, da bude isti sat, da se ne izgubi jedno za jedan.
Na vratima vašeg stana piše Tana velikim slovima i piše Ana Sijević, znači Tana Sijević. Tu ste negde pomirili ono, život u Americi i povratak ovde, konačno. Obično ljudi kažu svuda prođi, svoje kući dođi. Vi koji ste stvarno prošli svete i upoznali sve ljude, šta je bilans toga? Da li treba ići? Da li treba ostati? To su dileme mladih ljudi danas. Šta je ono?
Teško je odgovoriti na to, Miro. Ja se uvek nisam plašio da odem, a nikad se nisam plašio da se vratim nazad. To znači, treba biti otvoren prema svemu. Pošto nikad ne znate šta vas čeka kad odete, a ne znate ni šta će da sačekate kad se vratite. Međutim, ja sam imao sreću u životu da već preko 50 godina odlazim i dolazim i nadam se da ću da produžim dok sam živ, da odlazim i da dolazim.
Vi ste stalno se vraćali.
Stalno sam se vraćao. Čak i ako nisam mogu, u vreme kad nisam mogu da dođem ovde, kad sam pobegao, a mi posle mog besta 52. godine, nisam mogu da se vratim do 67. Vraćao sam se mentalno, ali fizički se vraćam od 67. godine.
Kažete pobegli. Koliko ste imali godina kad ste pobegli?
18 godina, avanturista. Gledao sam kaubojske filmove, slušao glas Amerike, mislio da je tamo raj. Međutim, vidio sam da može da bude raj i u stvari bilo je raj, pa bilo je paklo.
Je li bilo?
Naravno.
Hvala vama. Pa ću vam to da pričam, to je privatna stvar.
A?
Oni su nam dali pare za to. Šta ti je?
Slušaj.
A? Ja sam uzao pare.
Bogi, ja, sjećaš se, ja smo idi delili stan.
Ja.
I Bogi mene zove i kaže, nemoj da ideš kući. Kako da nemoj da idem kući? Kaže, nemoj neko tamo spava. Ako možda spava Bogi, ja moram idem u stan. On kaže, meni, slušaj, gazda ovaj bil gde ja radim i me zamorio da mu dam ključ. I otišao je Frank Sinatra i Marilyn Monroe, oni su u našem krevetu. Kažem, Bogi, nemoj da me zezaš. Kaže, ne zezam to uopšte, nemoj da ideš, molim te. Zaista, ja nisam mogu da idem kući, celu noć sam, do ujutru rano smo otišli kući. Kad smo došli tamo, bile su novi čaršafi i $100.
$200.
$200, 100 tebi, 100 meni. Ja sam upotrebio ti $100 da se iselim od Bogije, pošto nisam htio više da delim moj krevet niske.
Istina, ja.
A to je hotel. Istorijski krevet danas.
Ja,
sad ali, ali smo imali francuski krevet.
O ja, veliki krevet. Those were the good old days.
To je še.
Ja.
Kiss me. Kiss me, love, with heavenly affection. Oh, hold me close.
Nemaš čovjek da uspe u svemu, svačemu što radi. Imao sam ja i uspeha i neuspeha. Ali važno je imati više uspeha nego neuspeha.
Pa vi ste ih imali sigurno više.
Naravno da sam imao, ja sam dete sreće.
Holly has details in this extra exclusive.
It was an all-star tribute to the king of late night as America's comedy royalty united in Hollywood to honor Johnny Carson. And only extra has this incredible footage.
So we're together now.
Superstar comedians Jerry Seinfeld, Gary Shandling, Jay Leno, Chris Rock, and Bill Maher had a private gathering at Johnny's favorite restaurant, Dantana's, to remember the legend who gave most of them their big break.
And you know, I feel terrific.
Extra has learned that Rock was recently in contact with Carson to get tips about hosting this year's Academy Awards. Last night, the superstar comedy troupe reportedly got together in part to help Rock prepare his Academy Awards monologue, in which he'll pay tribute to Johnny.
We had all of them in before here, but we never had them all sitting at the same table.
Owner Dan Tana says it was a celebration of Johnny.
If he was able to hear what they are saying, I'm sure that he will be laughing all the way to heaven.
He has details in this extra exclusive.
Kažu, šta god ste dotakli, da je to prosto. Obično ljudi vas, znate kako, vi ste stalno prisutni u različitim varijantima. Vezuju vas za sport, vezuju vas za film. U Americi ste poznati i kao veliki donator i humanista. Pomagali ste svim našim ljudima koji se bave filmom i uopšte umetnošću. Na Kanskom festivalu, primali ste naše ljude tamo i tako dalje. Međutim, malo ljudi zna šta je zapravo vaše zanimljivo. Kad bi morali da popunete formular, šta bi napisali?
Sve i ništa. Naravno, mene interesuje sport, volim umetnost, volim biznis, volim da se bavim sportom i volim da gledam sport. Ja kad god uđem u nešto ili kad uđem sa nekim u nešto, ja želim da je to vrhunsko. Ili smatram da će biti vrhunsko. Naravno, ne znači da će biti vrhunsko. Ako je u fudbalu, ja želim da se kvalifikujem za evropsko i svjetsko prvenstvo. A kad se kvalifikujem, onda želim da pobedim. Ali nije sramota izgubiti. Ja mislim, sramota je ne probati. Ne probati, ne učestvovati. Mene nije sramota, ni sam ja preponosan sa uspesima, niti me sramota poraza. Ja mislim da je to važno u životu. Važno je u životu biti iskren prema samom sebi. Važno je u životu birati ljude. Ja sam... Ima puno ljudi koji su divni ljudi u životu koje sam ja upoznao, ali ima puno ljudi da je mene sramota da sam bio u njihovom društvu. Međutim, to je život. Ne možete vi da birate samo sve najbolje. Ako nemate ni ono što je loše, onda nećete ni znati šta je dobro.
Ima nešto što je jako zanimljivo. Ja sam vas imala priliku da vidim u različitim situacijama. Viđala sam vas sa američkim predsjednicima, sa američkim kongresmenima. Viđala sam vas sa ljudima koji rade kod vas u vašem restoranu u Los Angelesu, je li tako? Međutim, kada bi došla ovdje i razgovarala o vama i rekla ja bila sam kod gospodina Dantane, oni bi rekli on je kafeđija. Ima tendencije kod nas da ljudima umanje neke uspehe. Se slažete s time? Kako to?
Ja mislim na srpskom da? Je najveće umanjenje. Naš narod, ne znam zašto, žele da vas dignu, ali čim vas dignu, žele da vas tako brzo spušte kao da ste najvruća planeta ili raketa. Ja ne razumijem taj mentalitet. Mogu da vam kažem da i u Nemačkoj, i u Belgiji, i u Kanadi, i u Americi, gdje god sam bio sa ljudima koji su stranci, koji su me prvi put upoznali, uvijek su navijali da ja uspem. Jedini ljudi koji su bili zavidni, navijali da ne uspijem, to su bili naši ljudi. To znači, ne samo naši ljudi ovdje, mislim iz bivše Jugoslavije, ne govorim samo o Srbima, govorim o Hrvatima i Slovencima, Makedoncima i svima. Ne znam zašto to. Ja ne znam, možda je to neki balkanski mentalitet, možda, ko zna, Bog samo to možda zna. A ja ne razumijem, ja uvijek navijam, ja ne mislim da uvijek navijam. Ja čak i na kad mi je neprijatelj neko i znam da mi je neprijatelj, ja ne vjerujem da ta osoba uspije u životu, pošto ako što više uspije, bit će mi manji neprijatelj.
Da znate da je tako.
Pa jeste, istina. Ako je čovjek uspješniji u životu, imat će manje vremena za mržnju.
Ne, manje negativne energije.
Aha, totalno.
Jeste vi njima svima oprostili?
Oprostio sam apsolutno svima, ali se ne družim sa mnogo njima. Mnogo sam njima i pomogao u životu. Posle znanja da oni nisu moji prijatelji, da mi misle najlošije. Međutim, mogu da kažem da je moja bivša žena, moje bivše devojke, sve su ljubomorne. Kako ti možeš da budeš s ovim, sa ovim, pa ne vidiš da ti iskorišćavaju? Slušaj, oni mene jedino iskorišćavaju ako ja ne znam da mi iskorišćavaju.
A vi to znate?
Ja znam unapred da oni mene iskorišćavaju, onda oni mene ne mogu da iskoristiti ako ja znam da mi iskorišćavaju. To znači, oni mene iskorišćavaju. Ja im dajem nešto, pomoć ili neki savjet ili financijski rečima ili savjetima, ali oni mene ne iskorišćavaju. Naravno, čovjek gubi vremena, ali ipak treba da čovjek nađe vremena i za dobro, i za srednje, i za loše.
Pogledajte ovu kuhinju, kao iz prošlog veka.
To je gotova pileća supa. Ovdje imamo bolognese, odnosno meat sauce, koji se također sprema na starom receptu. Kao što je moda u odjevanju, tako isto imamo modu u kuhinji.
A šta je sad moda?
Pokušno došla je moda, teletine, bijelo meso je u modi. I polako vraća se ova govedina koja je danas na američkom tržištu jako, jako skupa. Danas ovaj steak mi ga naplaćujemo $43, a cijena na marketu je $13.50. Znači što je jako značajno za ovaj restoran je ta da ovaj restoran u biti imao samo tri šefa. Ja prvom šefu ne znam ime, drugi je bio Mate Mustać, treći sam ja. Prema tome, to je jako bitno zbog toga što obično restorani koji mijenjaju šefove nemaju ovakav uspjeh kao što ima Dantana.
Poput parmezana, kako se pravi?
Maslac. Vrhnje za kuhanje.
Dobro.
I parmezan sir.
I?
Na jednu litru vrhnja stavimo kilo sira. I onda kada postigne odgovarajuću temperaturu, kad se sir... Ne smijemo ga prekuhati i ne smije da bude temperatura, mora da bude odgovarajuća temperatura. Da bi se ta masa spojila u jednu masu i ona ostane lako. Kasnije stavljamo na tiganj i stavljamo u pastu i servira se tako sa pastom.
Welcome to Nine on the Town, everybody. This isn't a steakhouse at all. It's an Italian restaurant.
And since it opened more than 40 years ago, it has made its name on the L.A. dining scene.
It's not just famous for its steaks. It's also famous for its name and its celebrity clientele.
It's Dan Tanis.
Inside Dan Tanis in West Hollywood, the walls are covered in one-of-a-kind art and memorabilia. They tell the story of owner Dan Tana and his journey from Yugoslavia as a professional soccer player to Hollywood as a struggling actor turned film producer and restaurateur. When Dan Tana opened his restaurant in 1964, he decided to keep it simple, showcase one steak and make it the best.
Instead of having different types of steak, we chose the New York steak, but if we were going to have the New York steak on the menu, it was to be the best, and that still is true today.
Having the best meat is a great start, but a lot of magic happens in the kitchen, reflecting the caliber of celebrity clients.
George Clooney's been coming in here for 25 years. We knew George before the fame and the success. Matt Damon comes in, Brad Pitt comes in, Meg Ryan was here during the last week.
With LA's ever-changing dining scene, Dan Tanis has remained a hotspot for Hollywood's heaviest hitters. And the secret to that is great food and a quality experience. To try out this Los Angeles landmark, be sure to call ahead. Reservations are required.
So bring your sweetheart here for a taste of Hollywood and a delicious dining experience.
Fenomen vašeg restorana koji opstaje 40 godina, to je nezapamćeno u Americi. 40 godina vi imate taj restoran koji je skroman, zastareo, ima stolnjake na bele i crvene kockice, guraju se svi da uđu u njega, čekaju u redu najveće filmske zvezde i svi se trude da budu prijatelji sa vama kako bi imali vezu da uđu preko redu u restoran. Gde je fenomen? Jer to samo, da, slušajte, vi servirate 4-5 jela samo, ja sam bila.
Da, da,
imate 4-5 jela, a oni se tuku da uđu.
Miro, teško je to objasniti. Ja mislim, to bi mogli da objasnite moje mušterije, ljudi koji dolaze. To jeste jedan fenomen da je predsjednice države, da je velike zvezde, glumci koji naprave rezervaciju za 7 i 8 sati, čekaju po sat, 2 sata. I oni sami kažu, ne, nigde na svijetu. Ne bi ja čekao jedan minut ili kad uđem unutra, ako moj sto me ne čeka, ja izlazim napad. Međutim, ja ne znam šta je to kaže. Ja ovdje čekam sat, dva sata sa rezervacijom i ne bunim se. To znači ima nešto, ali ja ne znam šta je. Možda je lokacija gdje je ta zgrada. Šta ja znam, možda.
Možda je tako, izgleda kao baraka, nemojte da se ljutite.
Zašto
ja? Pa izgleda kao baraka. Ima jedan erkond, jer nema prozora.
To je najskuplja baraka na svetu. Bolje imati najskuplju baraku na svetu nego najjeftiniji nebo.
To je ono što ovdje ljudi ne shvataju. Kada čovjek ima ličnost i kada ima mogućnost da daje pozitivnu energiju, onda se oko njega skupljaju ljudi.
Pa, ja mislim da sam skupio što isto, moje radnice su, isto imaju pozitivnu energiju. Znači, mi smo jedna familija, ja imam 35 radnika tamo.
Ja ovdje sedim kao da sedim ovdje na ovoj klupici ispred restorana koji mu priređuje ručak i treba odjedan put da se iznenadim i da kažem ja, pa vi ste Karl Malden, pa kako ste? Da on ne bi znao šta mu je priređeno unutra. Čekaju ga njegovi prijatelji iz detinjstva, njegovi prijatelji sa kojima je snimio mnogo, mnogo filmova i svi oni koji su sa njim bili predsjednici Filmske akademije ovdje u Los Angelesu.
Ola Miller, and we're friends, and my husband, the director, Robert Ellis Miller, is parking the car, and we're delighted to be here.
We're very good friends with Carl. I'm on the board of governors at the Academy, and I worked with Carl for years at the Academy, and it's because of Carl I became president of the Academy after Carl nominated me.
Today we're drinking, we're eating pig, and we're having a party!
Ja bi se budu interesantno. Ište molde!
Što ovo? Uđutno je. Ej, kažem.
Okay, yes, thank you. Oh, my God! Hello! We know each other from San Francisco.
Oh, yes!
Carl Walden! My God, how come you're here? How come? You're here? Yes. Yeah.
Came for lunch.
Oh my God!
He's open, but he's next door.
We're gonna go next door.
Oh!
Yeah.
You're on the right place. You are on the right place. Hi, hi, hi.
We'll meet
some friends. Happy birthday!
Has someone been there?
Unforgettable in every way.
And forevermore.
And forevermore.
That's how you stay.
This surprise party was really a surprise party, except about 2.5 weeks ago, I got a call from an old friend saying, hey, I got a card from Dan Tanner, asked me to come for a birthday party. I said, when is that? He said, at 12 o'clock. I said, Dan Tanner doesn't open at 12 o'clock. 6 o'clock. He said, no. Oh, my God. He said, I haven't finished reading it. He says, it's supposed to be a surprise party for you. So I said, well, it's a surprise. He said, don't tell anybody, please.
3 days later,
I get a phone call from Connecticut. Richard Widmark calls me, says, I got a call from Dan Tyler. He wants me to come for a birthday party at 12 o'clock. He said, Jesus Christ, I'm going to come there for a birthday party. At dinner, maybe I'd come, but a birthday party, no. I said, who's it for? He says, it's for you. I said, well, read the card. He said, oh, my God, it's for you. He didn't read the whole card. So now I go to my wife and I say, what's going on with Dan Tanner on the birthday party? He says, I don't know anything. She walked away. I said, something's wrong someplace. So I came here. I was as surprised as I could be. But believe me, I knew for 3 weeks.
Restoran čujemo u Las Vegasu.
Ne, ja sam dao posle 40 godina mene jure da otvorim restoran na nekom drugom mjestu.
Prvo su vas jurili da prodate ovaj.
Pa to je 40 godina, ne. Poslednjih 35-6 godina od kako postoje restoran dobio svetsko ime, jure me stalno da prodam restoran. Ja sam odbio mnogo ponuda, međutim poslednja zaista jedna velika ponuda bila je na grupe glumaca i pevača iz Hollywooda, koje su moji mušterije, molim da ćemo da otvorimo u Vegasu Dan Tanac, u Vegasu. Ja sam na kraju dao njima to pravo i za jedno godinu i po dana otvorit će se u Vegasu Dan Tanac. I možda će oni posle toga da otvore lanac, ali ja sam samo partner, ali nisam izvođač radova. Biće drugi menadžment. Tako da, što se toga tiče, ja zadržavam pravo na kontrolu jelovnika i na kontrolu dekora.
NBC4, the Southland's number one late news. The Channel 4 News at 11.
Coming up, it's been a Hollywood hotspot for decades.
And tonight we'll show you what all the fuss was about when we come right back.
Before we go, we want to say happy birthday tonight to a legendary West Hollywood restaurant. Dan Tanez has been in business for 40 years, and local patrons were there tonight to celebrate. Dan Tanez has always been a popular hotspot for movie stars and sports figures. Here's Jerry Buss. The food is traditional Italian, lots of pasta and garlic and other good things. Dan Tanez on Santa Monica Boulevard near Doheny, next to the famous Troubadour nightclub.
Looks like there were a lot of well-fed people there tonight. Happily fed.
Having a good time.
Evo naš pasulj, ima čevapčića, kobasica, ima pita, zeljanica, svega ima. How do you feel when it's so crowded?
Hot.
You are an Oscar winner.
It could be it. I got lucky. Well, why couldn't I get lucky again? People get lucky for a whole lifetime. Some people don't get lucky. I got lucky one time, so, you know.
Očigledno ovaj zvuk koji čujete, neko zove da napravi rezervacije, verovatno za 10 ili 15 dana. Proslava 40 godine opstajanja jednog restorana u Americi pod istim vlasnikom je pravi raritet. I očigledno iz tog razloga je dat jako veliki publicitet. Jedan novinar kaže, u ovaj restoran ne možete ući ako vam bar deda nije bio redovni posetilac. A bacajući pogled na ovu sliku iznad mene, kaže, vodite računa da vlasnika ni u kom slučaju ne pomešate sa Hemingwayom. Što da vam kažem o ovom restoranu? Ljudi jedan drugome sede na glavi. Kada se prave rezervacije, možete ostati u restoranu jedva dva sata, ali uvek oni iz prethodne grupe ostaju i pridružuju se onoj tek pridošloj grupi i uvek je velika gužva.
Da bi svi mogli da dođu, gospodine Tana, vi ste uzeli i organizovali tako da imamo od 5 do 7, od 7 do 9, od 9 do 11 i od 11 do 1 sat posle ponoć.
Ja mislim svaki je termin eleti. Nema veze koliko je sati, pošto ne može da suđe.
Koga vidim?
Me, how are you?
Dazzling.
How are you? This happens to be one of the greatest film critics, journalists of the Los Angeles Times.
All around good sport and a great friend of Dan Tanez. What can I tell you?
Pogledajte koliki je spisa gostiju. Za mene piše da ću da dežuram čitave noći. Pogledajte koliki je spisak. Negde oko 900 ljudi treba da prođe danas. How long are you here?
47 years.
47 years, and I'm 25. Tell me, how it is possible to be unreplaceable as you are? Please
I never think me. Of myself no, that way. Exactly. All I do is do the best I can. I don't think of myself as irreplaceable. I don't think about the whole world. I just go on the air. Honest, I just go to work.
This is the only way.
My job is to learn as much as I can, draw as many guests out. But my opinion, I don't bring my opinion to the air. So it's not easy sometimes.
Yeah.
Because there's a lot of people I don't like, but I don't show it.
But you know,
you don't learn when you're emotional. In fact, if you're angry, you don't learn. You're high-spirited, you don't learn. The worst way to learn something is to be mad. Because you make the other party defensive. The other party gets defensive, they're not gonna reveal things. So if I'm mad at you, and you're my guest, and I go, why did you do that? Your first response will be, I'm not gonna talk to this guy, he's crazy, right? But I wanna learn from you. Supposing I said, why did you do that? Different way. Same sentence.
You decide who is going to be put on
no,
the air.
No, the producers do all the booking. Awesome. My producers book the guy. I do the show, They do the guests.
Everything what you put in your magazine is extraordinarily important for every actor, for every film.
I'd like to think so, yes. We try to get it right. You know, the actors are very jealous about what's written about them, so you can't afford to make mistakes.
How far you can go with the same profession in this city? It's not easy.
Oh, well, you could go forever. I don't know. I don't know if I will personally, but I mean, people have worked well into their 90s, you know. Personally, I don't know if I could take it that long. This city kind of eats you alive.
Yeah, because I think that the competition is high. And that, you know, when you are on the top, as you are, everybody's around you. And one day, you know, if it goes a little bit down, you are questioning yourself, what I'm doing, how long I can make it. Have you been thinking about?
I don't really think I would stick around. You know, I've got a lot of other things I like to do with myself. And I don't spend a lot of time. I'm never out here in Hollywood. And I probably spend about 4 months out of the year working on a movie, and that's it. So I don't think that I'd mind. I think I'm just going to ride it until it gets, you know, a little rocky, and then I'll just go off and paint or do something else.
Dobro veče, I say to everybody, and this man, ne prilike, loče. I don't want to get in the details. No, he's a very good man.
And I was I was taller than he was.
He was.
Then.
How come?
Well, you know.
He beat him down this movie. We worked him so hard. We beat him down. He was much taller.
Are you working these days together again?
Hopefully. I want to do 9 pictures in a row with him. He's a great man and a great friend.
He's so busy all the time.
Yeah, Mom. He lies about everything. Meanwhile, I read his ads around the other day.
He's a good golfer. I'm just kidding.
Okay, sweetie, I love you. I'll call you later. Okay. Let's go. Look how nice you look. Congratulations.
No, no, we know. Hello. Fine.
Nice to see you. Let me get this on for you.
Let me get this on for you first. I'll do a nice kiss for you.
Yes. Okay, let me tell you. Last time when we talked, you have been dealing with the diamond.
And oh, yeah.
And I was showing that on a television, and everybody was really amazed.
Oh, really? Oh, yeah. Yeah, and they're still doing it. But now we've got something really exciting.
What?
I'm going to be sponsoring... a spokesman for, we're doing a poker website for people who love to play poker because, you know, it's like a hobby of mine and Dan's and so on. And it's just been going great, where people get to play with celebrities online and so on. It's really fun, really fun.
How did you manage with Giuliani?
How did I manage it? Well, it was, he's somebody I admired, and it was, you know, he's such a very colorful character that it's very easy to sort of imitate and sort of capture his mannerisms. Although I didn't really try to do that. I mean, I just really just played the substance of the man. Oh, you want your mic back? You want it back? I've never done this before.
I danced with Fred Astaire.
Really?
Yeah. But I told him, I don't like to dip the first time we go out. You know what I mean? After that, it was all right.
How old are you?
103.
No.
103, that's right. Going to be 104 in February. Ask anybody, they know.
No.
Yes. You say no, I say yes. I'm lucky.
Marianne, 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 Shabbat Levie, Shabbat Levie,
Do you think that everybody's copying your style nowadays?
I would be, if I said yes, you'd think I had a head this big. I think what I actually did was create something that in essence gave other hairdressers an opportunity to create from that. In other words, they took it further.
In fact,
so I wouldn't say they're copying my style.
But you have been starting.
Well,
something
I think
new.
Maybe we inspired a whole bunch of people, and that's important.
And when Dan Tan is away, you are there?
I'm the one that basically runs the restaurant in the evenings. And it's my great privilege to try to figure out how to seat as many people as possible in such a small and popular place.
But you are an actor too. Does it mean that you gave up all the ambitions to be one of the leading actors here?
No, I mean, I still get a little bit of acting work. I'm in Ocean's 12, I'm in the Get Shorty sequel. I'm on a soap opera every now and again, as long as it doesn't interfere with my job here, because I love doing what I do. So I get the best of both worlds.
It's my birthday too, so I'm umbilically tied. It's true, she is.
it's a big, big accomplishment in a town where nothing lasts for very long. It's
interesting,
an extraordinary accomplishment. And yet it never feels tired, you know?
Never.
It always feels new, because it's not trying to be young or new, it's just trying to be what it is, so.
Čitava ova večera ovde priređena je naravno da se obeleži 40 godina postojanja Dan Tana restorana. Međutim, to je i povod da se sakupe sredstva za starački dom i to za one glumce koji su već ostareli i koji nemaju mogućnosti da zarade. I evo, ovo je bilo dato svim gostima da jednostavno prilože ček kako bi pomogli taj dom.
Jedna velika stvar, I mean, stotine, stotine hiljada će večeras da primi ova organizacija, ali jedna od velike stvari je lopta koja će biti potpisana od 40 najvećih zvezda i zvezdica Hollywooda. Dve će lopte idu na aukcion.
I čula sam da od toga dobije i 25% Jugoslovenska kinoteka.
Ako Jugoslovenska kinoteka bude pametna i pristala na ono što sam ja tražio od nje. A to je,
što ste tražili?
Tražio sam da se otvori specijalan račun, da znam gde te pare idu.
Cuando vos repetías y repetías y repetías.
¿Yo repetía? ¿Que repetía qué?
¡Soy mayonesa!
Nekad ostvarenje snova ne mora da se dogodi u Hollywoodu. To možda se dogodi na 13. kilometru od Lazarevca, ovde u Čibutkovici, gde je Dan Tana ili Dobrivoje Tanasijević ostvario svoj životni san.
Za ovaj kraj što je Bog dao i što je Bog kucnuo nas u srce našeg brata Dobrivoja Tanasijevića ili Dentane, kako ga Americi zovu, je tako da on, iako otisnuo se u beli svet, što bi rekao naš narod, vraća se svom korenu. Ovde gde je kršten, ovde gde je rođen, on je pobuđen upravo rodnom grudom i ljubavlju prema svojim roditeljima, prema svojim precima, prema svojim svetiteljima iz roda našega, poželeo je da ovaj hram materijalno pomogne i da ga ovako ukrasimo kako je ukrašen rukom našeg poznatog slikara Mate Minića i Mateja Minića.
jedno pitanje. Ispunjenje svih želja?
Apsolutno.
Nazad u Čibutkovicu?
Ja sam se ponovo rodio.
Po svetu, svuda i konačno svoje kući dođete?
Nigde lepše nego gde si počeo.
Šta je ovo ovde? Šta se osjeća sada?
Ovde osjeća se srce, duh. Osjeća se ono što mi je baba i mama dali i kad su me doveli na ovaj svet.
Ćerke?
Ćerke je...
Jesu razumele sve?
Jesu, ja razumijem.
Kako da ne? Kako da ne?
Katarina, jeste mislili da ćete doći u Čibutkovicu ovako, da doživite sve ovo?
Nisam znala, samo sam nadala. I tu smo, svi zajedno.
Tu ste sada?
Da.
Znači... Yeah, I can't even talk. Da, pa da, kako da ne. To je izvrsno.
Jeste vi verovali da će se to dogoditi?
Jesam, jesam, bio sam ubeđen.
On je bio od prvog dana. Zahvaljujući Slobodanu, mom bratu, najviše.
Jesam, sretan sam i presretan.
Pošao je brat iz Amerike.
Da. Brat je sve ovo učinio i uradio, sve najbolje za našu crkvu.
Ne, Slobodan je najviše uradio.
Ne, ne, pratim.
Ovako, da kažem, pošto smo bili u istom odelenju i tako dalje, sedeli u istoj klupi, jasno znam njegove vizije, kao takav, znači kao dete iz osnovne škole, i sanjao je o Hollywoodu. I govorio da ti idemo da budemo glumci. Normalno da ja u to vreme nisam imao prilike da ništa dalje kažem, jeli? A on je stvarno to ostvario.
A sada dolazi gozba posle osvećenja crkve. I šta se nalazi u kazanima? Idemo da vidimo.
U ovim kazanima se nalazi sarma za 1500 gostiju.
Jel da?
A ovde je čorba. Tamo je kupus. Isto za 1500 gostiju.
Koliko ste to dugo spremali?
Pa jedno 4,5 sata.
A reci ti meni, da li Čibutković zapamti ovako veliko slavlje?
Odavno nije lepše bilo slavlje, ni lepše spremljeno. Ja sam kuvar po profesiji. Inače, ovi su kazani, malo me dim seče, ovi su kazani, njima je imidž Ravna Gora i Rajac kod Ljiga, sve što radim, to je prva liga. Da, to sam. Ja sam kobac, kuvar.
E, probat ću se.
Hvala vam. Jeste, zim je malo.
U, i blato je, vidiš, šta ćeš? Ajde, za...
Prođe sve. Evite.
Kopečića, ne znam, došao u Ameriku, toliko sam imao garderobe, a rekao sam da neću napustiti u Ameriku dok ne napunim ovaj kopeč. Još ga nisam napustio, pošto sve što zaradim potrošim. Više brže potrošim nego što zaradim. A šta mogu? Kao ona naša pesma što ima siromasam, ali umem da živim. Ja sam rešio da ceo svoj život budem siroma, da umem da živim. A neka ovaj kufer bude prazan. Ajde, jano, kolo da igra. Ajde, jano, ajde, dušo, kolo da igra.
Ponekad u oca mi sad prođe ulicu mojom i stanem sam.
Evo, ovo je, vidite, ja restoran koji je restoran moje mladosti, a i restoran moje starosti. Tako u mom restoranu ne osjećam se tako prijatno kao što se ovde osjećam, pošto u mom restoranu me svi napadaju, ovde me niko ne napada. A ovde je bio, kad je u staroj Maderi, ovde je bio stol gde smo mi sedeli skupa godinama, godinama, kad sam bio mlad, sa pokojnim doktorom Macom Obradovićem, legendom našeg fudbala.
Ovo su dve lopte, jedna je iz 1904. a druga je iz 2004. To znači 100 godina od formiranja FIFA, koji su mene poklonili za moj rad u FIFA, a koje sam ja želio da ostavim u uspomenu pokojnom Maci Obradoviću i društvu Maderi, da se srećemo meni.
George celebrated his win until 3:30 in the morning at Hollywood hotspot Dan Tana's, just a few blocks away from Vanity Fair.
Other post-Vanity Fair revelers spotted Oscar winner Rachel Weisz, along with Naomi Watts and Uma Thurman. Look, it's Madonna, lightly posing for pictures with hubby Guy Ritchie, but she quickly reaches into her purse for a cell to do a little texting before heading inside. Watch Mama Madonna's mad dash to her awaiting car. Was this just a cover for Clooney?
George pulled a little bait and switch. As Madonna left through the front door, George evaded the paparazzi by sneaking out the back door.
By the way, do you want to marry again? Do you want to settle down? How old are you, George?
I'm thinking about doing it today.
Today?
Maybe.
We got a few girls here.
I'm taking numbers.
How old are you?
44. But I have the liver of a 72-year-old.
I'm too much time at Dan Tana's.
Exactly,
right?
Yeah. Sitting in the corner, drinking.
Since most people who date go out,
right?
Unless you hide in the house,
right?
You go to dinner.
Sure.
People see you at dinner with a girl.
I've seen you at dinner at Dan Tana's.
Okay. So they see you at dinner with a girl. It's natural to assume.
Right.
Therefore, someone would ask you.
Sure. And that's a fair question, and they're allowed to ask it. But I just never answer.
Now it's time.